Let's bring in the World Series champion, former MLB executive, and our man to talk baseball with. He is David Samson, the host of the Nothing Personal podcast with David Samson. David, I'll start by getting your reaction. $115 million for Alvarez on a six-year deal.
Well, talk about cost certainty. You're talking about a player who has not even gotten to arbitration yet. Next year would have been his first year, so he has three arbitration years, and then he'd first become a free agent in 2026. So they're getting 3 years of free agency, cost certainty, and they're keeping him in the center of that lineup in Houston. It's a very interesting decision because what we're seeing is what the union was fighting for, and that is the universal DH, because DHs are getting paid as though they're position players, as though they're pitchers. And Yordan Alvarez has now started that train rolling. And that's a huge win for the union because there's 30 of these jobs in baseball now. Yeah,
David, what does this money do for that DH market moving forward?
Well, you're talking about $26 million in free agency for a player. No question he's a positive offensively. He's not a negative defensively. He just doesn't play defense. So the question is, does this now move up position players? Because if I'm Aaron Judge, as an example, where I know that I'm playing the field and I'm going into free agency, for me, I'm now looking above Scherzer. I'm looking above Betts. I'm looking above Lindor. Where does it stop? If I'm Juan Soto, $500 million? For sure, $50 million a year is not a big deal. So one of the concerns that Major League Baseball owners have is what do we do to curb the very, very top of the market? But a signing like this shows that there is no end in sight to what the top can be.
David, we have to obviously talk about the move for Jeremy Peña, the move not for Carlos Correa. How did that move enable this to happen?
So when you're putting a team together, remember the Astros had signed Altuve long-term. They have Bregman locked up. When you are putting your team together, you have to have, in addition to highly paid players, you have to have some performing players who have not yet reached arbitration. And when Carlos Correa did not re-sign with the Astros, that was a purposeful move, knowing that they actually were going to reallocate that money elsewhere because they had a replacement for Correa. And that's the dream of any president of a team, is to have a minor league system where you can put in a player like Peña into shortstop and really not lose a beat if you're the Houston Astros. And so you're really looking ahead, not just 1 year, but 2, 3, 4 years. And look at the Nationals, if we could bring them up. They traded away Trey Turner because they wanted to allocate their money before they were going to sell to Juan Soto. So teams are doing this all the time, and that's just what the Astros did with Carlos Correa. And to me, it makes absolutely perfect sense to do that. So we'll see what happens going forward.
David, before we came on, you told me to ask you this question before we went out. Who is the happiest person in the world after hearing this news?
So as a president of a team, we used to do something fun, is when long-term deals were signed, we would make a list, like top five happiest people that this deal was done. Very often, the owner of the team who did the signing didn't make the top five, the manager, the president, no. It was players at the same position on other teams who are going to benefit from the increase in salary from the particular signing. So if I'm JD Martinez, I'm aging a little bit. I'm older than Alvarez, but I'm going to be a free agent as a DH. Forget Nelson Cruz. I'm going for $26, $27, $28 million. And you know what? JD may very well get it. He's got to be the happiest guy in town.
World Series champion, MLB executive David Samson joining us to talk about Yordan Alvarez getting a six-year, $115 million contract extension with the Astros. Thanks for hopping on with us, David. This will be one of many topics up for discussion on David's podcast, Nothing Personal with David Samson. You can download and follow wherever you get your podcast audio. You can also watch the program on YouTube.
Do you want a sports network that delivers everything that matters about the game? The highlights, the picks, the instant analysis. No yelling, no fake debates, no politics. Hit the subscribe button and never miss a moment.